Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. I am Mr. Super Tech Song. In my channel, you will be learning some new skills from Malay language and English language. Without wasting much time, let's go! It's on 40 in my right car. Business change, yeah, I like dying hard. Get it money, make it up on me. Hi everyone, today we are going to write essay again, which is giving opinions. So this time around, we will be writing a letter on a trip to an island. Have you been to any islands before? If yes, this is a great time for you to write such an essay. Okay, I know you can't wait for it. Let's go! So this is the instruction. So every time when we do essay, I will remind you again and again that you must read the instructions given. You went to Semporna Island in Sabah with your family recently. You did a lot of fun activities there. Okay, for your information, this Semporna Island is very famous in Sabah. Do you know where Sabah is? I guess you know, right? You must know Sabah is one of the states in Malaysia, and Semporna Island is one of the famous islands in Sabah, right? So you went there with your family members. You did a lot of fun activities there. So for your information, usually when we go to an island, the activities will be more or less the same. We'll go for a picnic, we'll go snorkeling, diving, canoeing, and so on and so forth. So you must have knowledge on all of these activities, right? You would like to share your joy. It means you were very happy. You were very happy because you went to the island and you did a lot of things there, and you want to share your joy with your friend. So you are going to write a letter to him or her. So your friend can be a boy or your friend can be a girl, all right? So telling him or her about the interesting activities that you had done there. Okay, so you can tell anything. Okay, so if you yourself, you went there before, but this is an exam question, so we have to look at what is given. So basically, this is how the Semporna Island looks. Okay, the water was crystal clear, as you can see, and there is a hard island, I can say, a very small island there. Okay, it's in hard shape, so fantastic. Okay, and you can look through the water and see the base of the sea, and we have some cottages here. Not hotel, but it's more to resort, and this is how it looks. Okay, so I guess if you have the opportunity to visit the place, it's worth going, right? So now this is the timetable, or I can say the tentative, written by the writer, right? So the idea. So day one, he went snorkeling. You know, when you go snorkeling, you need a snorkel. Okay, you have to put up like, it's like a tube so that you can breathe. Okay, and then having seafood as dinner, for sure dinner you have it at night. So during daytime he went for snorkeling, and at night time he was having seafood as dinner. Okay, for day two he went canoeing, okay, or we can say it as kayaking. And the last activity that he had over there is buying souvenirs. Alright, so now for Sabah, they have many races over there. They have Kadazan, they have Dusun, they have many races, many different races, which we don't have in peninsula of Malaysia over here. So you can see a lot of local handicrafts. Okay, they are well made. Okay, they were made of beads and so on and so forth. Okay, it's worth buying if you go there in the future. Okay, maybe you can grab some of the cloth that they make and some vases, okay, so that you can keep them as a remembrance. Okay, so usually we buy souvenirs because we want to keep it as a remembrance of our visit. So next time in the future, when you look at that item, you can recall your sweet memories over there. Maybe you went there with your lover, alright, and okay, so you can recall your sweet memories, okay, by looking at the items, right? So now, let's look at the explanation of the activity. So usually when we write this kind of question, we have to put in our own ideas. It's very important, right? So now usually when you go snorkeling, okay, you go into the sea, the water was crystal clear, and you are able to see a lot of unique marine creatures. Unique means special, marine creatures means, okay, the water creatures. So in the sea you have fish, you have stingray, you have sharks, okay, maybe you can see the baby shark, okay, and a lot more. So, and you yourself, you were attracted by the colorful coral reefs. Actually, they are not stony corals, okay, because all these microorganisms, they grow on the rocks, okay, so they form coral reefs, okay. And you saw a school of fish swimming towards you, and then you touch them because they were tame, okay. They are not sharks, they are not going to eat you up, okay. Tame means they are not wild, they are not very fierce, right? So, and let's look at here, okay, when you go to have seafood as dinner, for sure you will go to a famous restaurant, or you will go to a nearby restaurant near your hotel because it's convenient for you. And usually on an island, the seafood will be delicious and fresh enough, am I right? So you can have crabs, you can have fish, grouper, you can have shrimp, prawns, and so on and so forth. Okay, and you don't tell me, teacher, I had a mermaid before on an island, the seafood that I ate was a mermaid. Okay, so that is impossible to happen. Okay, let's look at day two. Okay, this is why you name it as canoeing or kayaking. Okay, so it means you have to paddle to row the boat and to row the canoe. Okay, so this is what you call a canoe. So you need to paddle the canoe carefully so that it would not overturn. Okay, this kind of canoe, it can easily overturn if you cannot remain balanced. So now it needs you to work hand in hand, to cooperate with your team members, okay, and by doing so you can enhance your relationship. So from this activity you learn that cooperation is vital, cooperation is important, okay, to succeed in doing a task, okay. So it's important. And let's get the last one, buying souvenirs. Okay, you bought some local handicrafts for your friends and classmates. So, and you yourself, you wanted to keep some of them as a token of remembrance. A token of remembrance, it means you want to remember the thing, okay? You want to keep it as your memory, okay, with an item. Can you understand? Okay, so that's what we call souvenir. So usually you, as I said earlier on, okay, you keep that thing so that when you look at that item, you can recall your sweet memories at a certain place. Okay, now first of all, we are going to write a letter to our friend, and we must be familiar, okay, with the format of a letter. So on the top right we have our address. So usually we'll write very simple address, okay, like my 7 Jalan Besar 11900 Bayan Lepas Pulau Pinang. So if you want to write even shorter, it depends on you, as long as if, okay, you were to deliver that letter or you were to send that letter, it can be successfully sent, right? So now after the address, you will have the date, Okay, so remember you have to write the date in English, 3rd of June 2020 or any date that you like. And then after that, you will have a salutation. Okay, name your friend. For example, your friend is Ivan, so you write Dear Ivan. If your friend is Clement, okay, Ming Yang, Wen Yao, or anyone, just name them. Okay, so make sure if you write Ivan, please use he. Okay, none of the girl, they are named as Ivan. And the first thing which is very important in a letter is greeting. How are you? I hope you are in the pink. Okay, in the pink means I hope you are healthy. Okay, so that's it. Okay, for our second paragraph is very important because all the main points will be here. Okay, your first sentence will be your purpose of writing the letter. So here I'm writing to tell you about my trip to Semporna Island in Sabah. So keep it short. Okay, this is your only purpose. So usually it's not given in your question or even in the instruction, but try to write out on your own. I'm writing to tell you about my trip to Semporna Island in Sabah. I did a lot of fun activities there first. So you continue telling your activities like I have showed you earlier on. And the third paragraph will be your closure, that's all by. And then at the bottom, okay, right bottom, you have your, this one, signing off your friend's super tag. Okay, now, as I mentioned just now, the second paragraph is very important. So as a practice, I want you to write all the four points given above. So it means you not only writing three, but you write all the four ideas. Okay, again, I'll explain. I'm writing to tell you about my trip to Semporna Island in Sabah. I did a lot of activities there first. So your pronouns to be used will be I. Remember, don't use you, use I. First, I went snorkeling. First, listen the sentence. First, I went snorkeling. You cannot write first, I went to snorkeling. After two infinitive verb, you cannot have ing. And the word snorkeling should be with double L because we follow the British spelling. Can you understand that? So, I went snorkeling. So, when you were in the crystal clear water, you can write, I saw a lot of unique marine creatures. Okay, if you want to name one or two, yes, possible, please go ahead. If you don't want, you just stop over there. So, I saw a lot of unique marine creatures. Okay, I was also attracted. You got attracted by what? The mermaid in the water? No, I was attracted by the colorful coral reefs. Okay, as I mentioned before, okay, they are stony corals, which means the microorganism or this particular creature, they live around or on the rocks. Okay, so they form coral reefs. Okay, suddenly a school of fish swimming towards me. And I was scared. Luckily, they didn't attack me because they were tame. Okay, you can write anything. Okay, suddenly, a school of fish swimming towards me. Okay, luckily, they did not attack me because they were tame. Okay, now, at night, my family and I went to a famous restaurant. We had delicious and fresh seafood there. Okay, so at night, my family and I went to a famous restaurant. We had delicious and fresh seafood there, such as crab, shrimps, and so on. Don't write mermaid again. Okay, so the second day in the morning or the second day, we went canoeing. Okay, canoeing. So I needed, or my sister and I needed to paddle the canoe carefully. It means to row the canoe carefully so that it would not overturn. Okay, so that it would not overturn. This activity can enhance. Okay, since you are writing in past tense everything, can, you can change the can to could. This activity could enhance our relationship. This activity could enhance our relationship. Okay, full stop. I also learned that cooperation is important. Okay, before going home, I bought some souvenirs. okay, at the shop, okay, at shops, okay, full stop. I bought some local handicrafts, okay, you can buy vases, you can buy mats, you can buy shoes, you can buy clothes, and so on and so forth. I bought some local handicrafts for my friends and classmates. Okay, for sure, I bought one for you too. You can mention that. For sure, I bought one for you too. Okay, I would keep some of them as a token of remembrance. Okay, that is your second paragraph. Okay, so if you have any questions, please don't feel awkward or don't feel shy to ask. Okay, everyone? Okay, I hope you can learn something from my video. Not only watching me, I know I'm very handsome, but the most important thing is you must learn something new from each of the videos. That's all for today. Bye. If you like my channel after watching my videos, don't forget to subscribe and like my video. That's all for today. Bye.